proof.
Big Blue, coached by Gino Fair, assisted by Mike Delicio. And now for your Marblehead Headers. At left wing, number 6, Carter Laramie. At center, 17, Chris Locke. At right wing, number 16, Connor Sheridan. On defense, number 4, Lyndon Dyer. His defensive partner, number 28, Cam Patrick. And in goal, number 35, Griffin Winter. The headers are coached by Mark Marfion and assisted by Liam Gimmick. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and remove your caps and play the national anthem.
Hello and welcome on into the Rocket Arena here at Salem State as we are just about set to drop the puck on the most highly anticipated hockey matchup of the year. The Big Blue, technically the away team today, but we are here on Swampscott Big Blue Athletics. My name is Dawson DeBerry as the Big Blue take on their longtime rivals, the Marblehead. I guess they're called the Headers in hockey, but the Big Blue coming in at 10-4 on a 6-game win streak. And Marblehead comes in at 8-4-3 in Division 2. It should be a good one. It should be nothing like the 10-1 blowout Marblehead gave Swampscott last year. The Big Blue in some old uniforms tonight. The throwback alternate uniforms wearing red on Marblehead night. It's going to be Ronan Locke, Ryan Frary, Liam Herlihy, Zach Ryan, and Frankie Pappalardo starting the game for the Big Blue as we are set for action. Say, packed crowd here at Salem State, and everyone has been waiting all day for this matchup. Ronan Locke's going to take the faceoff against his cousin, senior captain from Marblehead, Christopher Locke. And here we go. The game is on here from Salem State University. The Big Blue on a 6-game win streak, trying to beat Marblehead as there's a big hit to start it on Frary. And we are in the Big Blue zone with Zach Ryan chasing it into the right corner. Lot of physicality early for Marblehead. The turn and a shot. And Jason Bouffard has been really good in his last two starts. Makes his first save on the shot from Carter Laramie. Jason Bouffard coming in one goal allowed in his last two games, including a shutout against the Minutemen Mustangs. Just 19 seconds of the game, Marblehead has it in their own zone. The turnaround shot save made by Bouffard as it goes wide. Ronan Locke gets pinned into the boards. A lot of physicality now already shown by the Magicians. Laramie gets around Hurley, lays an offensive check. Big Blue cannot clear the zone. Now this is Locke of Marblehead. Puck loose along the left boards. And we're gonna get an early penalty. We'll see who it's against. It's gonna be against Beverly as Bouffard heads to the bench. Little too physical early for Marblehead, and They're going to get possession of the puck, and the Big Blue will go on the power play for the first time tonight. 13:58 to go in it. Just getting underway from the Rocket Arena in Salem State. The Big Blue had an 8-0 win in their last game as they took care of the Minutemen on the road for the second time this season. And the power play unit is going to be Roddy, Fea, Locke, Hitchcock, and Baljinkov. Baljinkov's going to go to the bench. Now he comes back on. Miscommunication with who was on the ice. Fea wins the draw. Baljinkov gets it back to the point where Hitchcock is there. Hitchcock right to Baljinkov. Baljinkov down low for Derek Fea. A big hit, but Swampscott retains possession. It goes to Baljinkov on the left wing, trying to tap it ahead. Hitchcock keeps it in at the left point and throws it down low for Baljinkov. That was Fea on the left wing. Now here's Roddy behind the net. Can't get it through. Baljinkov tried to feed it into the slot. It ricochets out to Hitchcock at the point. And the pass cannot connect with Fea, and Marblehead clears the zone. Hitchcock first of the puck that way. Hitchcock's going to drop it for Ronan Locke, who has a ton of speed. Ronan Locke gets around one, what a move. 2-on-2, reverse Locke right down the left side, the shot, and it's off a stick. Pops in the air, pucks loose, a great save, loose again. Locke shoots it, blocked in front. Still loose. Action-packed first minutes here. Pucks loose, Fea with a shot, and it goes wide and high out of the out of play. What a couple of great chances for the Big Blue there. Could not get it by the senior goalie in Griffin Winter, and they'll stay in their zone with the faceoff. Roddy communicating with Ronan Locke as Fea gets ready for the draw. Marblehead wins it cleanly. And Sedke's first of the puck, trying to clear it, and the bank gets it through. And Hitchcock recovers for the Big Blue. Now here comes Fea. Now Locke. Big Blue of numbers here. Roddy gets it in. Clean entry on the right. He's going to drop it for Locke in the slot. The shot and the save by Winters. Ronan Locke found himself free in the slot, and Winters squared up and made the save in his chest. The Big Blue still with 40 seconds on the power play. We'll have another draw in their own zone, or in their attacking zone. Great start for the Big Blue as they are on the power play with Laramie in the box. Fea will take the draw. Same five out for the Big Blue. Fea ties up the draw, puck loose. Roddy's gonna get there first in the right corner. Now here's Roddy, back pass for Fea, does not get to him, and it's thrown around the boards. Papalardo kept it in momentarily, and Marblehead gets the clear with 25 seconds to go on the power play. Hitchcock speeds around his own goal, looking to make a play in the neutral zone, gets it to Roddy, who gets a clean entry on the right. Roddy looking for Locke across. Gets it to him. Now Locke puts on the brakes and will reset the power play. Locke now to the top of the umbrella in the offensive zone. Locke rips it from the point. Loose in front. Roddy taps at it. Shot and a nice save. Winters keeping the game tied here. Still 0-0. And the power play of the Big Blue is over. So Marblehead survives, but the Big Blue gained a ton of momentum in their offensive zone that entire 2 minutes. We'll see if they can build off of it. Big Blue still shorthanded without Dakota Landrevan and Aiden Sprague. So the third line stays Aiden Fitzpatrick wearing number 11 tonight. Jackson Bartram and Ryan Wood. And now Marblehead speeds up the left side. The shot from the left point, and Bouffard knocks it down with a blocker and covers up for his second save of the night, and Marblehead will get a offensive zone face-off after the shot from James Sarin. Fitzpatrick wins the draw. Ryan gets it to McCarthy. And now here comes Ryan Wood. He finds Fitzpatrick, takes the hit to make the play, pass in front of Bartram. Ryan's going to get there first, gets into the slot. Woody with the shot. Blocked down and now taken out by Sedke. Now Sedke taking it up the right side, makes a move around McCarthy, tries for the wraparound attempt, goes the other way, wraps it around, trying to put it in on the Buffard. He could not. He gets it to first in the corner, and Ryan Fitzpatrick, or Aiden Fitzpatrick, gets there first. Now Ryan Wood will dump it in and go for a change as the third line will get off the ice for Frary, Herlihy, and Locke. Hear the Marblehead chants from the Marblehead student section. Ronan Locke with a shot from the left, and it goes wide of Winter. Tolosa slaps it back into the zone. Locke lifts the stick and shoots, and a save made by Winter. Ronan Locke getting those shots on net early. 10:42 to go in the first period. Still deadlocked at zero in the rivalry game here on a Wednesday night at Salem State. Locke wins the draw to Hitchcock, who's going to rip a wrist shot, blockered away by Winters. Winter, sorry, I'll get that down. Good work by Hitchcock on the back check. Hitchcock gets his stick lifted. It comes loose in front, popped into the air, and Tolosa collects it behind the net, makes a nice move to get it to his D partner. Hitchcock now trying to get it out of the big blue zone, spins around one nicely and gets it out. He's gonna take it himself up the right wing. Hitchcock's gonna rip a slap shot, loads loose in front. Ronan Locke scores! The big blue go up 1-0 on the 19th goal of the year by Ronan Locke. And the big blue are buzzing early with 4 minutes and 56 seconds in. They take the 1-0 lead. Ronan's 19th of the year, his 36th point, as he is almost doubling the second place player, Derek Fayo, with 21 points on the year. Big blue up 1-0 early, and they have the momentum here on the road, technically, at their home ice, Salem State. Marblehead on their senior night. Big blue trying to pull off the upset, even though they do have the better record. Nice stick by Faye in the neutral zone. Now here comes Roddy. Roddy is going to dump it in, looking for Faye. Faye hustling for it, working in the corner, but is held off by Ben Wales. Ryan pokes it ahead for Roddy. Faye finishes his check on Dolan. Roddy has it, trying to clear the zone. He gets it out. Baljinkov tips it ahead. Here comes Baljinkov, but first of the puck is Dolan. Good job getting back by the senior, by the sophomore. Long and direct. Baljinkov trying to get there first. Tipped ahead by Sedke. Sedke gets met at the blue line by Bartram in the long and direct. Cannot connect with Locke, but he got the stick on it, so it's no icing as he goes into the boards hard and lays a good check. Fitzpatrick frees the puck, and now here comes Frank Pappalardo, clears the zone, but that's about all he can do. Gets it to the red line and lays a big hit, but it's gonna be an icing, I believe they're gonna call, as we have some pushing and shoving between Sedke and Pappalardo after the hit, but they call an icing, and it's gonna be a big blue attacking zone faceoff. Great start for the big blue. Now here comes Marblehead on the attack off the faceoff, and offsides is called. 1-0 Big Blue early, 8:31 to go in the first period. Ronan Locke back out there after putting the big blue in front on his last shift. Hurley can't collect it on the boards. Good stick by Zach Ryan to poke it free for Frary. Frary dumps it to nobody for the big blue, and Marblehead collects. Frary battling along the left boards. Now in the corner, it's Sarin. Across for Sedke. Sedke to the right dot. No angle to shoot it yet. And a lot of contact in front with Ryan. Now on the wraparound attempt, they get it back down low. Behind the net, Ryan battling. Good job, and Locke controls it. And we'll get it low for Hurley in being chased. Nice move to get around the hit. And he gets it now and gets a clean exit out of the zone. And here comes Hurley. He's going to fire wide off of the end boards. And it's cleared by Marblehead. McCarthy shoots it into the Marblehead bench. 7:29 to go in the first period. The Big Blue up 1-0 on the goal from Ronan Locke as the faceoff comes to center ice. Hitchcock at his own blue line, can't get the pass through. Now getting battled for it. And Marblehead has it. They get it in front. The shot fanned on. Comes loose in front. Bouffard way out of the net. Puck is wide. Bouffard trying to get back in the net. Now everything settles down. Hitchcock trying to get the puck free. Cannot. Now it's loose in front. Save made by Bouffard. I'm not sure if it got through. Maybe it went off of a Big Blue defender. Puck loose. Good job by Baljikov to get it ahead. He couldn't get it to Roddy. Now Hitchcock battling behind the net. Marblehead first to the puck. Now in the corner, it's a battle for it with Fea jamming at the puck now. Hitchcock, it's a 2-on-2 on the end boards. Puck still stuck in that corner. Hitchcock hits it free. It comes to the slot. Roddy there, good positioning on defense, and now here he comes. He has Baljikov to his left trying to go through. Three guys cannot get it all the way through. Now the Big Blue in the middle of a change. Marblehead's got some space with Sarin. Sarin, the drop pass and the shot. Does not get through the block by Ryan. It's loose in front, still loose. The shot, and Bouffard find. No, he can't find it. It's still loose. And the backhand attempt by Fitzpatrick clear doesn't get out. Puck loose in the corner as they're still battling for it. Marblehead with a long offensive zone time. Ryan trying to clear it. It gets off of his own man, and Bouffard makes the right decision and dives on it. And we have a lot of pushing and shoving in front of that. No love lost between these two towns. In any sport, there's always going to be a heated matchup. 5:57 to go in the first period. The Big Blues still leading 1-0. We'll see if we get any penalties here. It looks like Papalardo's going to go to the box, and the Big Blue will have to go on the penalty kill. Now the Big Blue on the penalty kill. Marblehead wins the draw to start the power. Papalardo got a roughing penalty. It comes to the bumper, the shot goes wide of Bouffard, puck's loose, and Hurley, he clears the zone. Marblehead trying to knot this game up on the power play. Speeding up the left side is Sarin. Ryan does a good job containing him. He couldn't find a shooting angle. Sedke at the point. Back to Sarin. Loose. And Hitchcock cannot clear. Good keeping by Sedke. Sedke looking for a pass. And the pass. And the shot saved by Bouffard. And now Ryan from his knees can't clear it. Hurley trying to slap it out. Didn't get much of it. And now it comes back to the left dot. The pass to the right. The shot goes off the stick of Hitchcock and out of play with 53 seconds to go in the power play. Bouffard with a huge save sliding to his right to keep this one knotted up. 4:50 to go in the first period. Marblehead wins the draw cleanly. Rodowski with it back to the top of the point. And it comes to the right wing, the pass across the slot. Rodowski not in position for it. Now back across the slot, the shot. Save made by Bouffard through the screen. And the Big Blue will have another faceoff to go against. 32 seconds left in Papalardo's minor roughing penalty. Marblehead wins another offensive zone draw as it comes to Hogan Sedge, one of the senior captains on this team. And now the shot from the right off the post, it stays out. And now a move around the slot, thrown in front, off the stick of Bouffard, he keeps it out. 18 seconds to go on the power play, the shot off the legs, and a good block by Roddy, and it clears the zone with 10 seconds to go in the penalty. Roddy, a little shaken up as he got that one right off the shin, he goes to the bench. Now Marblehead on their last rush of the power play, lock. Keeps them from the clean entry, and they have to clear the zone, and the Big Blue kill the penalty off as Papalardo off the out of the box, and that's going to be an icing as Locke couldn't get a stick on it, but the Big Blue penalty kill does the job and keeps this game 1-0 with 3:50 to go. Marblehead still with an offensive zone faceoff. Locke's going to take the defensive zone draw. He wins it back for Hitchcock, and now Hitchcock will try to set up a breakout. Hitchcock's going to chip it ahead, looking for Hurley. Marblehead got a stick on it, and it comes all the way to center ice where McKenzie is right there to scoop it up. And that hit somebody on the Big Blue bench, and it will come outside of the Marblehead zone for a faceoff. Locke couldn't get the handle on the pass, and McKenzie couldn't do it either. They can't clear the zone, but it's going to be an offside. As Marblehead carried it in, someone was already in the zone. Papalardo and Ryan back out there as Hitchcock ends his long shift. Ryan taps it ahead, looking for Locke. Locke couldn't get there first. Good pinch by Sedke. Ryan, the D-to-D pass for Papalardo there, looking for Locke in the middle of the ice. And he gets control of it already with a goal in this period. Moves around, won the shot, and the save by Winter. What a move by Ronan Locke. Could not sneak it by as Winter steps up and makes the save. Frary in pursuit of it in the corner. Marblehead gets there first and will get a clean exit out of the Big Blue zone. And now here they come with speed across the neutral zone. It's kept in at the blue line after the poke check. We're going to get a penalty on the Big Blue as they're going to go back to the penalty kill. As I'm not sure what we got, but I believe it's going to go against Ronan Locke, and it is. So he'll go to the box for the for 2 minutes out of the 2:35 remaining. In the first period, the Big Blue still leading 1-0. We'll see what the call is. Marblehead power play will go back to work. They got some chances but could not get one by Bouffard. They'll go back to work on the run and lock penalty. Faya cannot win the draw and it comes back to the right point. Now back to Dolan. Dolan. It's going to be a holding call on Locke. And it's loose in front, and Marblehead knots the game up as Grenier was right on the doorstep, and this one is a 1-1 game with 2:22 to go in the first period. Bound to happen as we see the replay. He took it right to net, loose off the save from Bouffard, nothing he could do. As Grenier knots this one up. 1-1 as now Marblehead has the momentum. Locked now out of the box, however, though. Ben Wales throws it through the offensive zone. Papalardo collects for Swampscott, gets hit off the puck. And now the pass in front, and Marblehead trying to go right up. And it does not exit the zone as Wales did a good job hustling to get it back into the zone. Fea trying to tap it ahead for Roddy. Wales keeps it in. And now the pass through the slot. And Greg Bowdenkopf will be first to the puck. Gets it ahead for Roddy, who has Fea with him. He's going to give it to him. Fea goes along the zone. It comes to Bowdenkopf looking for the shot. He couldn't get it out of the skates of Fea. Now Marblehead has some numbers as Roddy hustles to get back. And now it's a 3-on-3 rush. Both teams in the middle of a change. A cut to the middle and a save by Bouffard as he squared up nicely to Laramie, who found himself open in the slot. Laramie, a senior captain for this Marblehead squad, one of the 9 seniors who got recognition before puck drop, as it's Marblehead senior night here. Puck loose off the draw as it never came out, and it ends up in the pads of Bouffard, and it'll take another draw. One-to-one game with 1:27 to go in the first period. Marblehead has knotted it up after the opening goal by Ronan Locke with a Charlie Grenier goal as the puck shot into the slot. It never got through to Bouffard in the skates of Hitchcock, and he gets it out for Frary, who's going to get it out of the zone. No icing, I don't believe. As we are about to go, 1 minute to go in the first period. Now Sedke gets his stick lifted by Frary, but he stays on the puck, throws it to the front of the net, and Hitchcock there to collect off the ricochet. He gets it ahead for Ronan Locke, who's trying to get to the left wing, and he gets hit hard into the boards. Clean check there. The long stretch pass for Sedke. He can't get it through, and Tolosa's going to have to recover the puck for the Big Blue. Goes around the boards for Frary. Frary trying to tap it ahead. It's a bad turnover, but luckily Marblehead could not keep it in the zone, and it's cleared 25 seconds ago in the period. 1-to-1 game as a highly contested first period continues and rolls on as Christopher Law can't get it through Hitchcock. A great defensive play. Hitchcock gets it out of the zone where Hurley collects it, takes a big hit to move the puck, but he couldn't get it through. Locke. Locke now with the shot. Hits Bouffard up high, and someone flying over Bouffard. But he seems to be all right. With 4 seconds to go in the period, Marblehead will get one more chance with a faceoff in their offensive zone. Faceoff's going to be on to the right of Bouffard. 4 seconds to go in the period. We'll see if Marblehead can get one last shot off. It would be a heartbreaker for the Big Blue to go out of this period trailing with how well they have started this game. Puck loose off the draw, and Roddy takes it, and that will end the period. And it's going to be a tie game 1-1. As the goal is by Ronan Locke to start it, and then Charlie Grenier. And it's a 1-to-1 game after one in this highly anticipated rivalry night here on Swampscott Big Blue Athletics. Thank you. welcome back into the Rocket Arena here at Salem State as the Big Blue and the Marblehead are knotted up at 1 through 15 minutes. Ronan Locke got the scoring underway 4 minutes into the game and gave the Big Blue a 1-0 lead, but Marblehead struck back in the late goings of the first period with a goal from Charlie Grenier off of the rebound. So it's a 1-1 game here on Rivalry Night on Swampscott Big Blue Athletics. Thank you for joining us as we are set for puck drop in the second period. The Locke cousins will tie up on the draw again. This time Ronan wins it. Pappalardo can't get it ahead. And puck rolls all the way in on Bouffard, and he's going to play it to Zach Ryan. Marblehead now gets control in the corner. They had the, and the pass in front. Beautiful save by Jason Bouffard. Marblehead controlled the offensive zone time in that first period, but the Big Blue able to capitalize on their only power play to keep the score knotted up. Bouffard has been really good in goal so far. Puck goes wide to Bouffard. And goes around the boards for Pappalardo, who can't get it ahead. Now it gets to Ronan Locke on the left wing with speed. Ronan Locke takes it up the left side, throws it in front, looking for Frary or Hurley to get a stick on it. They could not, and they cycle it back, and it's going to be Lyndon Dyer first to the puck, and it's thrown ahead looking for Locke. That's going to go for no icing. They say Locke beat the play down the ice, and Frary does a nice job getting into the corner, hustling back. Liam Hurley to the puck, gets it to Ronan Locke. Ronan Locke speeds up the right side, loses the handle initially, trying to make a move, but a nice play there by Hogan Sedke. So now he has it going to the net, and the shot and a save as Sedke went hard into Bouffard. Hopefully everyone is okay, as that was a big collision there. I think early in the broadcast I said Sedke was a senior captain. He's a captain, but he is a junior. Bouffard seems to be all right, shaking it off in the corner off the big collision. He's going to need a second to get his pads back on. Sedke goes over, taps him on the head. Everything good between those two. Bouffard will get back in the net. Rodovsky to the right of McDonald on the draw. Puck comes, TJ McCarthy grabs it off the draw, makes a nice move to get it to Baljinkov. And now here comes Derek Fay up the left side, and it's taken away by Hart. Baljinkov can't get control of it. He wanted a penalty. TJ McCarthy throws it into the skates of Dolan. Now here comes Marblehead speeding up the left side with, this is Hart. Hart goes around the net. Dumps it for Rodovsky. Good job by McCarthy containing, but Marblehead keeps possession in their own zone. Now coming to the slot is Hart. Hart can't get a shooting angle, and he gets it back to his defenseman. Hart now has it in the corner. Hitchcock battling with it with Fea. Long shift for this five for the Big Blue. Puck comes loose and Hitchcock first to it. Hitchcock makes a nice move to get away from Rodovsky. He gets the puck to Greg Baljinkov up the left side. Baljinkov, he's got Roddy Middle, throws it the tip, and a goal! It's Quinn Hitchcock! And he goes to the student section for the Selly, and the Big Blue have a 2-1 lead! The feed from Greg Baljinkov to get it to Quinn Hitchcock. Hitchcock made the initial pass to Baljinkov. Baljinkov did a nice job looking for the stick of Hitchcock, and he tips it in past Winters, and the Big Blue have a 2-1 lead. .12:40 to go in the second period. The Big Blue have a one-goal lead once again. Bartram now gets it to Fitzpatrick. Back to Bartram, who's going to have a shooting angle, then the muffin goes in to Winters, and we got some pushing and shoving in front of the net. and someone knocks Fitzpatrick all the way to the ground. And now there's a fight between Fitzpatrick and Waldman as tempers are flaring between the longtime rivals. We'll see who they get for penalties, as the initial hit came in on Fitzpatrick and he wanted his get back after that. We'll see who they take to the box, as there's definitely going to be some conversation here between the officials. They'll probably take Fitzpatrick and whoever laid the first hit, I believe, I'm going to assume. Yep, we're going to go 4-on-4 for 2 minutes. It's going to be... Oh, no, they're going to just take Marblehead to the box as Fitzpatrick was doing it in self-defense. That's what they call Woody's going to... No, it's going to be Jackson Bartram going to the penalty box, coming in aid of Fitzpatrick as the mess is finally fouled out. We're going to play 4-on-4 for 2 minutes. Coach Faye is really upset by that call. Normally never see him get up off the bench, but there he was talking to the official. Couldn't tell if he was upset or just clearing the air with the official. Oh no, they're going to stay 5-5 with the offsetting penalties. All right. Papalardo gives it away, and now Waldman with a step. Throws it middle, and a good play by Ryan to stick it away.
Quinn Hitchcock.
Ronan Locke now with the puck is going to take it around Bouffard. He cycles it for Frary, who's going to have to get rid of it quickly. He gets it taken away by Grenier, who has the goal for Marblehead. Now here comes Ronan Locke, gets it to Liam Herlihy. Herlihy throws it. Waldman has it in front. It goes wide. It stays in play. Grenier has it in the corner. The shot from the left point is tipped in front, loose in front. Bouffard sticks the pad out, and he gets the penalty. He gets the stoppage. As we have Nick Paradise, he wants to say hi on the broadcast.
What's up, guys? Sadly, the Big Blue Girls took a tough loss, but you know it's looking good for the boys right now. It's getting a little rowdy up in here. I'm already saying some stuff to the Marblehead fan section. I already got threatened to get kicked out, but you know, let's go, Big Blue.
Message there from Nick Paradise coming straight from the girls basketball team that was streamed earlier on Swampscott Big Blue Athletics. Wanted to say hi to the hockey stream. As the puck comes free in the Marblehead zone, they take control of it. Thrown in front, the shot, and it sneaks through the pad of Bouffard, and that's one he's going to want back. And Marblehead ties the game right back up. 2-2 game as this one is a really good game from Salem State. 2-2 with 11:36 to go in the second period. Bouffard's gonna want that one back as it just snuck by his pad. He's been good. Well, hopefully he keeps his confidence up. He's been good tonight, keeping the Big Blue in it as Marblehead has controlled the offensive zone time in this one. 2-2 game, 11:36 to go in the second period. Baljinkov off of the skate of Fea, trying to find Roddy across the zone. Papalardo chips it ahead on the boards for Baljinkov, who had the assist on Hitchcock's goal. Baljinkov looking for help, can't get it by Dolan, who made a nice play on the end boards. He gets it ahead and now gets it back, trying to get it out of the zone, and he'll get a clean exit. Roddy first of the puck on the pass, but now here comes Marblehead. This is Sarin. Sarin leaves the puck behind. He skates by it as Papalardo goes into the corner to battle him. Excuse me, that's Faye in the corner. It's given away, and Bouffard makes a nice save to keep this game tied. Now Roddy couldn't get it out, and it stays in the zone. They pass it through the slot, and a good poke check by Papalardo. Pass behind Roddy, but he's going to be first to the puck. Roddy's going to dump it in and go for a change. Bad pass. Faye has it now. He couldn't get it to settle on his stick. Buck comes around Fitzpatrick, trying to contain the exit from the zone. Fea trying to get a change. The cross pass for Locke. Christopher Locke, Ronan Locke's cousin. Dumps it in deep where Tolosa's gonna have to collect it. Marblehead goes for a change. Tolosa can't get it to settle on his stick, and it's loose in the corner of the battle for it. It's kicked out, and Marblehead controls it with McDonald. Now back to the point, and the wrister from the point goes wide. Ryan Wood trying to get it to the corner. He couldn't pop. Tolosa now has it. Ronan Locke can't clear it out. It's coming free in the slot. The shot goes wide. They couldn't get all the shot there. It's dumped back in. Marblehead with a long offensive zone time. Popped into the air, and Ryan Wood gets to it. They can't get it out. Baseball batted out of the air. McDonald keeps it in deep. Ronan Locke is going to ice the puck mercilessly as the Marblehead had a minute plus of offensive zone time, and that will continue as Ronan Locke's line will join him on the ice now as it's a 2-2 game, 9:32 to go in the second period. One goal apiece here in the second frame. Hitchcock for the Big Blue. I'm not sure who they credited the goal to for Marblehead. Believe it was Laramie. Thrown in front and sticked away by Ronan Locke. Thrown in front and a good stick lift, and it looked like a trip, nothing called. As it's dumped back into the corner for Zach Ryan, who gets boarded on the play, and the Big Blue will go on their second power play of the game as Ronan Locke, trying to keep the possession, gets a big hit, and Marblehead finally gets possession, and the Big Blue will go on their second power play of the night, where they are 1-for-1. They are 0-for-1. The goal came right after the power play in the first period. So a chance for the Big Blue to go in front. The boarding penalty is going to go against Cam Walden, who hit Zach Ryan into the boards there. Power play unit's going to stay the same for the Big Blue. It's going to be Papalardo and Hitchcock at the D-line with Ronan Locke, Derek Fea, and Will Roddy out there as the forwards. Marblehead wins the defensive zone draw. Roddy chips it ahead, looking for Fea to control it. He could not. Now Chris Locke trying to clear the zone and does, and Ronan Locke will have to recover the puck, being chased by Sarin. Locke makes a nice move around him and will look to find some space to roam. Ronan Locke takes it right up the middle, now goes to his left side, speeds into the zone, takes the shot, did not get through to Winter. Gets back to the end, to the blue line, to Hitchcock, who dumps it in deep. Ronan Locke to Will Roddy. Will Roddy looking for help, gets it down low for Ronan Locke, who gets hit into the boards nicely by Dyer. Locke still down as the puck is beneath him. It squirts out to Hitchcock, who throws it in front. Fea is open. Roddy with the backhand. And a save by Winter. Did not get through to Fea. Roddy tried the backhand, and Winter was up to the task. Still a minute and 9 seconds to go on the Big Blue power play. Same five is going to stay out there for the majority of this one, as Dyer will get a change for Marblehead. Locke ties up the draw, and Roddy first to the puck. Back for Derek Fea. Down low to Roddy. Roddy waiting for Fea to go down low, down to the slot. Good stick work by Marblehead, but Papalardo now has it on the left wing into the skates of a defender, and now Marblehead almost had a 2-on-1. Hitchcock first to the puck. Papalardo working on the boards. Pass too far for Derek Fea as they can't connect, and it's cleared away by Sedke. Papalardo gets it to Locke. Locke now along the left side, trying to make a move around one. We'll reset it now. Still in possession of the puck. 30 seconds to go on the power play. Papalardo now. Papalardo moves around one, finds Roddy on the left dot. Roddy looking for a pass. He's going to get it back to Papalardo. 20 seconds to go on the power play. Hitchcock now on the right wing. Throws it across. Roddy's open. The shot right into the chest of Winters. He couldn't get the one-timer off. Comes back to the point and out of the zone. Last rush, that's going to be, can't touch it, is Roddy, and that's going to be the end of the power play as Marblehead's PK does the job. Hitchcock now to Papalardo. Papalardo with space. Papalardo up the right side. Slows down, through for Fitzpatrick, trying to get it across for Locke, could not. Fitzpatrick battling forward in the corner, dumps it down low. Roddy's going to go for a change, and Marblehead's going to get a clean exit. Looking for the stretch pass, and they get it. It's a breakaway. Chris Locke, the shot, and he scores. 3-2 Marblehead as Chris Locke scores on the breakaway as Big Blue defensemen get caught down too low, and it's 3-2 Marblehead with 6:35 to go in the second period. Christopher Locke got the stretch pass and took it in all the way on Buffard and beat him to the glove side. Nothing Buffard can do. Now on the ensuing faceoff, the third line out there as McCarthy tips it ahead. 2-1 answered goals by Marblehead, making it a 3-2 ball game. Hogan Sedke on the assist on the stretch pass. Puck comes loose behind the net. McCarthy left it behind him and it gets taken away. Now looking for a pass. Thrown into the skates of Fitzpatrick. Fitzpatrick with a hit and a good one. And Ryan taps it ahead. Can he get there first? He cannot. Now the puck comes loose. And now looking for a pass in front. Thrown in front through the slot. Nobody there. And now here comes Dyer. Dyer has it on the left point. The pass across the open net in a 4-2 game. As the Big Blue just could not clear the zone. And Sarin makes it a 4-2 game as Marblehead with three unanswered and two in the last minute. And this one is close to getting out of hand for the Big Blue. 4-2 Marblehead. Big Blue looking for a force that can settle down this team. Ronan Locke trying to fire them up at center ice. Still plenty of time to go in this one. Over 20 minutes left in this hockey game. Zach Ryan makes a nice move to get around one. And now here comes Hurley, who gets it to Ronan Locke, who gets hit off the puck instantly. Frary can't tap it ahead. Here comes Hurley battling along the boards. And Marblehead gets it free, and they have a rush now. The pass in front, the shot save made by Buffard. TJ McCarthy gets it to Ryan Frary, who taps it ahead looking for Locke, but he couldn't get much on the pass. And it exits the zone. Marblehead tags up. Now the pass and a good poke check by Frary, but it's not out of the zone yet. Frary taps it ahead. Frary does it again and clears it, but it comes right back to Marblehead with McKenzie. Locke tried to make the hit at the blue line. And now the pass for a shot. Blockered away by Buffard. Long rebound comes out to Marblehead. The shot from the left point and a score. It's 5-2 Marblehead as now they have four unanswered goals. And this one is getting away from the Big Blue. I'm going to put this one on Nick Paradise. He said it was looking good, and since then it's four in a row. For Marblehead, it's 5-2. Now, late in the second period, the Big Blue need something, and they need something fast. Roddy now has it on the right wing. Gets it to Faya. Faya's going to shoot it. Goes just wide. Bautenkopf trying to get it into the middle. Could not get a stick on it. Roddy lays the body there on the right boards. And now Hitchcock has it at the point. Hitchcock already with the goal. Throws it low, looking for a rebound. Bautenkopf throws it into the skate of two Marblehead defenders. And now a one-on-one rush. Tolosa the only man back at Sedke. Speeds up the wing and the shot. That was Monaco, sorry. And now Grenier dumps it down low. Bautenkopf tips it for Hitchcock. Hitchcock gets it ahead for Greg Bautenkopf, who gets an exit out of the zone. Tape to tape to Roddy. Roddy now down the middle of the zone. Could not get through the three Marblehead defensemen there. And now ahead is there's a breakout, but he could not get it. And that is a lot of contact, and it's going to be a penalty against Marblehead. And the Big Blue will get a chance before the second period ends to get this game to two as the power play will come back on 5-2 game. Marblehead with four unanswered goals after the Big Blue took a 2-1 lead. This is almost a must-score situation for the Big Blue power play. Down by three, looking to go into the third period with at least some momentum as Monaco drew the penalty. Ronan Locke's going to take the faceoff against his cousin. He wins it back for Hitchcock. Or Tolosa, excuse me, is on the power play unit this time. Puck comes loose. That's another penalty on Marblehead. So the Big Blue have a huge 5-on-3 chance, as two penalties in 10 seconds for Marblehead open the door for the Big Blue to get this game within two, as we have more words exchanged by these two teams in the corner. This is a huge, huge, huge spot for the Big Blue. They're going to go 5-on-3 for almost a full 2 minutes with 3 minutes and 5 seconds to go in the second period. That is Patrick going to join Monaco in the box. 5-on-3 situation. Locke wins the draw cleanly. Over to now Papalardo across for Fea. Fea is going to throw it in front. It comes to Locke in the left slot. The shot! And a save by Winter. Locke wins the draw to Roddy. Back to the point for Hitchcock. Hitchcock now across for Locke, who has an angle to shoot it. Shoots it wide as it was off a stick. Roddy gets it to Locke. Locke now open, 5-on-3. Plenty of space for the Big Blue to work. And what do we got? There's a whistle as the net is off of its pegs. Still a minute 23 of 5-on-3 action for the Big Blue. Puck loose off the draw. Marble is going to get a chance to clear, and they do. And now here comes Sedke. One-on-one rush is going to shoot it, and into the chest of Buffard it goes, where he saves it with 1:13 of 5-on-3, 1:24 total in the both penalties. Big Blue control it off the draw. Still plenty of time on their 5-on-3. Hitchcock now is going to control it for the Big Blue. Hitchcock going to drop it for Ronan Locke. The Big Blue stay on sides as Locke glides through the offensive zone. Locke now looking for a tip, gets it back and never got through. There's pass in front. Fea misses wide. Ronan Locke now has it, 40 seconds of 5-on-3 to go. Hitchcock at the right point for Papalardo. Puck loose in front, still loose. Fea trying to punch it by. And the net's off once again, it looks like. Fea does a nice job to keep it in. Fea's going to find Roddy with space. Roddy trying to make a move around one. We'll get it back to the point for Papalardo. Now Hitchcock. Hitchcock's got room to shoot. He fires high. And it's going to leave the Big Blue zone. 14 seconds to go of 5-on-3 time. Big Blue will hurry up. 18 seconds of power play time in total. Quinn Hitchcock. Quinn Hitchcock goes around the net. We're 5-on-4 for 10 more seconds. Out of the box comes Monaco. Papalardo. And Monaco gets there and clears the zone in the Big Blue. Frustrating. 1:50 of power play time, and they cannot score. Now Hitchcock almost gives it away for Monaco. And now the pass across. Now through the slot, Ronan Locke first to collect the puck. We are in the final minute of the second period. Locke makes a hit to move it ahead for Bartram. Bartram has it. Bartram looking for help. and he can't get it through. It comes back to the point where Fitzpatrick tried to line up a slap shot to keep it in, could not get anything on it. Papalardo gets it in deep where Winter plays the puck. And that's going to be no icing as Papalardo collects it with 15 to go in the period. Pass doesn't connect with Ryan. And now here comes Fitzpatrick. Fitzpatrick's going to drop it off. Here comes Jackson Bartram. He's going to tip it for running lock. Makes a nice move around one. 5 seconds. Gets a shot in on Winter. And the disaster of a second period comes to end for the Big Blue as four unanswered goals by Marblehead makes their lead 5-2 going into the third.
Shot the puck.
Welcome back into the Rocket Arena on Swampscott Big Blue Athletics. The Big Blue just had a rough second period and now find themselves down by three going into the final frame. We'll see if they can get back into it, or is Marblehead going to beat them for the second straight year? Big Blue need a Herculean effort from their team to come back in this one. They have to score early and often, and they cannot let in anything. It's going to be the Fea Roddy Baljinkoff line. Actually, they're going to go Roddy and Fea along with Ronan Locke. This is their most skilled three forwards on the ice in desperation mode, trying to beat Marblehead as we are about to be underway here in the third period as Ronan Locke wins the draw. Now, tip pass for Ronan Locke, the shot saved by Winter. Ronan Locke speeds through the zone, but Sedke gets control of it and throws it up ice. Tipped ahead by Laramie. Hook comes to the left boards for Granada. Now Ronan Locke has it with a ton of speed, moves around Laramie, but leaves the puck behind him. Zach Ryan tips it ahead, but to a Marblehead stick in Granada. Puck rolls in on Bouffard. What a really tough second period. Now here comes Ronan Locke. Nice move around one. He gets into the big blue zone. Moves around two more. The shot from, wow, falling down and a save by Winter. A great rush by Locke. They need more of that this entire period. Hitchcock now fresh on the ice. Gets it to McCarthy, who gets it to Ronan Locke, who will go once again. Now Will Roddy gets hit by Hart, and he goes for a change. Now Baljinkoff joins Frary and Hurley out there on the original first line. And now here comes Hart on his right. Good stick work by McCarthy to get it away from him. Now here comes Baljinkoff across for Frary. Frary has some ice to work with. Frary's gonna pull up and left the puck behind him, could not get a shot off. He keeps it in the zone, now has it in the slot and off a stick and out of play as Kyle Hart got the stick on it to redeflect it out of play. Big Blue need a quick goal here to keep them in this one. 5-2 lead for Marblehead. Early he wins the draw. McCarthy pinches to keep it in. Hitchcock was staying back. Ben Wales behind the net collects it for Marblehead. Now here's Cam Waldman. Lifts the stick of McCarthy, who goes down hard, who lost an edge. Now the puck loose in front, and Greg Baljinkoff first to it. Cannot clear the zone, it's kept in. And the shot from the point save made by Bouffard, long rebound. And Monaco could not settle it on his stick. Off more offensive zone time for Marblehead, where the Big Blue have struggled mightily to get it out of their zone. Puck comes free for McCarthy, too far for Baljinkoff, and it leaves the Marblehead zone. And they go for a change. Swampscott going with the third line. This time Jason Rothwell gets the nod over Ryan Wood. Good contain by Ryan, but he could not get a stick on the puck. Puck comes into the corner. Collected by Bartram, who gets it middle for Jason Rothwell. The freshman normally plays defense, but now on the forward third line. For the banged up Big Blue, Sedke now has it. Looking for the stretch pass, kept in the zone nicely by Fitzpatrick. But Marblehead will now get the clear. They can't get the stick cleanly on the puck, and Papalardo has it. Gets it to Rothwell, dumps it in deep. Sedke now. Pass too far, and it's going to go for an icing, which is going to get the first line back into it. 3 minutes and 32 seconds into the third period, the Big Blue trail Marblehead 5-2, looking to get back into this game. They have sent out their best three forwards in Locke, Roddy, and Faya. Dakota Langevin is up there as well, but he is unavailable as well as Aiden Sprague, who hasn't played in four games. Puck comes loose into the corner. Roddy trying to slap it for Faya. He couldn't get it by Dyer, who flips it into the Marblehead zone where Ryan's going to have to recover. Marblehead gets control. Laramie can't get the shot on net, and now here comes Roddy. Gets it to Ronan Locke on the left side. Ronan Locke looking across for Roddy. Bats it down. Could not get a clean shot. Faya trying to pinch down to keep it in the zone. Locke does. He shoots it right into the chest of Lyndon Dyer. Hitchcock in a race for it. Couldn't get there before Sarin, who has a goal in this game, gives it away for Faya. Locke goes behind him to catch the puck and stops on a dime looking for Faya, and the slot couldn't get enough on it to get it to him. And now here comes Sarin. Sarin drops it as McDonald comes speeding into the zone. Pass too far for Sarin. The slap all the way across the zone where Wales keeps it in at the point. Tolosa with the steal. And it comes for Hitchcock behind the net. Hitchcock looking for an outlet pass is going to get it for Derek Faya, who gets it to Ronan Locke. Pass too far for him. And now here comes Ryan Frary with space. Frary drops it off for Locke. And now speeding into the zone is Baljikov. The one-timer goes wide. Frary couldn't get enough on it. Baljikov, the backhand goes wide. And the net is off its pegs once again. 5 minutes and 21 seconds into the third period. The Big Blue still trail by three. They need a goal, and they need it now. Herlihy battling in the corner for it. Wales is there for Marblehead. Herlihy with a nice check, but he can't get the puck free. As Grenier, who had the first goal for Marblehead, takes control. Good stick by Hitchcock, but nobody there for the Big Blue. Herlihy now can't get it by. Now it's still loose in the slot where Marblehead takes control. Hitchcock now ahead on the boards for Baljinkov. Baljinkov trying to find Herlihy, gives it away. The shot does not get through, and it's in the corner where it's going to be popped out and out of play. And a good catch by a student in the Big Blues fan section as the puck popped out of play. 8:53 to go in this one. Where the third line is back out there. Rothwell's going to be first of the puck. He's got some space but can't control it. Gets hit along the boards when he dumps it in deep while taking the check. And into the bench the puck goes with 8:32 to go in the game, and a quick shift for the third line as Locke, Faya, and Roddy head back out. 5-2 game, 8:32 to go. Off the draw, Marblehead wins it. It comes to Roddy on the right side. He's going to dump it in deep as he couldn't get full control of it. Dyer now first to the puck for Marblehead. Pop-up pass indirectly for Sarin. Pass into the slot. Locke recovers for the Big Blue. He can't get it out. Pappalardo does. No, he can't. He's still in. Good keep in by Marblehead. Ryan went down, but he gets up quickly enough to get the puck to Roddy, and now here comes Ronan Locke trying to make a move around one, couldn't get around him. Faya can't get it past Laramie. And Laramie, McCarthy loses an edge. Laramie the shot into the chest of Bouffard, and he makes the save. 7:42 to go in the game. Locke with a nice pass for Roddy. Roddy dumps it in deep ahead of the check from Hart. Marbley gets it right back. And they clear the zone easily with Hart. Now Hart, the 3-on-2 rush. Hart trying to get in on Hitchcock, who does a really nice job keeping him to the outside. Hitchcock, Swampscott, easily Swampscott's best defender. Faya went for the hard cross-ice pass for Roddy. Ronan Locke takes it, cannot get it across the blue line as McCarthy recovers it off of the boards and into the zone where the Big Blue have to go for a change. McCarthy ahead, too far for Ryan Frary as Wales collects the puck for Marblehead. 5-2 still, 6:30 to go in the game. And the pass in the slot right into the chest of Bouffard as he makes the save as Grenier cut middle. Time is running out on the Big Blue. 5-2 game, 6:24 to go as Marblehead trying to move to 9-4-3. Swampscott trying not to fall to 10-5 and end their six-game winning streak. Puck thrown in front. Papalardo battling forward. It's still loose. It comes in front of Bouffard. Off of the skate of Ryan, it goes to the corner. Frankie Papalardo collects. He takes it up the left side, all the way behind the net himself. Throws it in front, looking for the stick. It's loose. Papalardo on the wraparound, and the puck comes loose. And here comes Marblehead. Waldman now on the right wing, throwing it in front, looking for Sedke. Sedke now in the corner, battling with Ryan. Sedke keeps control of the puck. Puck loose and it comes free. Still loose. Marblehead keeps it in their zone, long time in their zone here. Over a minute of offensive zone time. Frary trying to battle for it. Cannot get it free, and that's a big cross check to the head, and that is gonna be a penalty. That was a blatant one there from Connor Sheridan. I don't know what he was thinking was gonna happen there as he just put a cross check into the head of Frary. So the Big Blue get a chance on the power play, trying to cut the deficit to 2 with 5:09 to go in the game. Power play unit comes back on for the Big Blue. Locke wins the draw for Hitchcock. Hitchcock protecting the puck, gets it to Ronan Locke, who gets it back to Derek Faye, who gets it back to Hitchcock. Faye crosses zone for Locke. Locke chips it. The saucer pass under the stick of Faye, and Marblehead's gonna clear easily. Hitchcock too far ahead for Ronan Locke, and Marblehead's gonna get another easy clear. One-on-one rush, good play by Hitchcock. He is just so steady on that defensive zone play. Ronan Locke finds Faya cutting to the slot. Faya now takes it down low. Faya for Hitchcock, back to Faya. Faya gets hit to the boards, puck comes free. Now Roddy in the right quarter. Across the slot for Locke. He has an angle to shoot off of a Marblewood defender. 55 seconds to go on the power play. Roddy now finds Faya below the net. Back pass for Roddy is sticked away by Sedke, and he's going to get an easy clear as the frustration for the Big Blue power play continues. Sedke's going to take it all the way up himself. Can't get a shot in on Bouffard, where Ronan Locke collects it with speed. Makes a move middle, loses the handle momentarily, spins around another, keeps the puck on a stick somehow. And he's going to draw a penalty, even though he got his stick caught. And we're going to get a penalty on Ronan Locke and a penalty on Marblehead. So that's a huge blow. Two out of the 3:34 remaining. Ronan Locke's going to be in the box as Marblehead looks like they're on their way to beating Swampscott once again here at Salem State. There you go, there it is, cleared up. 3:25 to go in the game. Marblehead's gonna beat Swampscott here at home unless something insane happens. And with them controlling the offensive zone time like this, it is not gonna happen. Bartra plays the body on Sedke. Getting a cheer from the Big Blue fan section. Hitchcock goes down now. That gets a huge cheer from Marblehead's fan section. Bartram steals the puck away. Bartram on a one-and-one rush. He's going to fire a shot into the glove of Winter. The Big Blue will most likely fall to 10-5, snapping their six-game winning streak. Under 2:30 to go. Laramie now with the puck. Laramie goes across the zone and makes it a 6-2 game as he sneaks it by Bouffard, and that's gonna do it. As the Swampscott fan section starts to empty, I'm sure the Marblehead fan section will have something to say about that. Baljikov drops it for Hurley, who takes the shot and it goes wide. Tolosa gets it at the right point, gets it to McCarthy. The Big Blue are on. On the power play, who was roughing after his goal. And not going to matter. Big Blue on the power play for the rest of this one. But four goals, too much in a minute 20, so. Ronan Locke is out of the box. Roddy gives it for Ryan at the point, shoots it through the slot. Faye couldn't get a stick on it, and Christopher Locke clears it. Ronan Locke with a self pass. Takes the shot, saved by Winter, who has been really good. Locke tried to lay a big hit. And we have action. Out of the play as Locke is going at it. Punches are being thrown by Ronan Locke and Lyndon Dyer, and that could hurt the Big Blue in the next game, as we'll see if a suspension is handed out. There was a lot of fists thrown. Locke's gonna definitely go to the box. He's been ejected with 51 seconds to go in the game, as frustration just set in for the senior. And Dyer's going to go to the box as well. Jackson Bartram will serve Locke's penalty. So referees get this one situated. Swabsgut's gonna fall the Marblehead. Hopefully nothing comes after this one, as Ronan Locke got ejected from the game. Hopefully no suspension coming. Locke got a 5-minute penalty. It's a 5-minute major for face mask on Ronan Locke. Yep, roughing penalty on Dyer. 4-on-4 for the final minute of this one is Derek Faya trying to get on the score sheet. Puck comes to Hitchcock, who has a goal in this one, saved by Winter. He makes another one on Faya. Now Roddy behind the net. Roddy to Hitchcock, the shot save by Winter. And that's gonna do it for this one, as the Big Blue's 6-game win streak is over, as Marblehead defeats them 6-2 at Salem State. Thank you for joining us at Swampscott Big Blue Athletics. My name is Dawson Berry, and we'll see you tomorrow night for boys basketball action. Good night.